A drink or two never hurt anyone, right? Celebrations and get-togethers always seem merrier with them. And a few drinks a week even point to lower cardiovascular risk for adults. Drinking responsibly and occasionally usually never hurts anyone. But a hidden danger lurks in imbibing spirits with high alcohol content. Methanol poisoning. This is what a man in Vietnam found out when he and his friends drank rice wine that they purchased from a local mom-and-pop shop and almost died. According to the World Health Organization, the major toxic effects do not manifest until methanol has been metabolized to formic acid and this has accumulated to toxic levels. In the first few hours, the patient may become drowsy, unsteady, and disinhibited. However, since poisoning often occurs in the context of drinking alcohol, this may not be noticed. After a variable period of time, victims start to develop headache, vomiting, abdominal pain, and vertigo. They may start to hyperventilate and feel breathless. Vision is often affected, with blindness in severe cases. Coma, convulsion, and death from respiratory arrest may ensue. Patients who have survived may suffer permanent visual impairment. Methanol is a naturally occurring chemical in fruit juices, in trace amounts, and is non-toxic. It's also a byproduct of fermentation along with ethanol. Yes, that thing that gives you the euphoric feeling with drinking alcoholic beverages, and can be found in fermented alcoholic and non-alcoholic fermented drinks. In lower concentrations, like those found in beer, methanol is not harmful. Higher concentrations are produced when distilling spirits. Expert distillers, those who commercially produce wine, rum, whiskey, and the like, use specialized methods to remove methanol to make these alcoholic drinks safe for consumption. Small backyard operations, though, with poorly managed distillation processes, might not have the knowledge or experience to remove them, inadvertently making these alcoholic drinks poisonous and even lethal. Methanol poisoning can often be misdiagnosed as alcohol poisoning, which can delay proper treatment. On December 25th, Christmas Day of 2018, three men were rushed to Quang Chi General Hospital in Vietnam, all in a coma, including 48-year-old Nguyen Van Nhat. Fortunately, they were able to quickly and correctly diagnose him with methanol poisoning after showing symptoms 2 days after imbibing rice wine at a party. Doctors were able to determine through lab tests that Nhat had over 1,100 times the safe level of methanol. Nhat's wife was much perplexed when doctors told her to purchase cans of beer for her unconscious husband. Doctors then immediately infused Nhat with 3 cans of beer, then 1 more every hour for the next 12 hours. But wait, you can use beer to treat methanol poisoning? Not quite, but the beer served as a distraction while doctors had Nhat go through hemodialysis. You see, the human body prefers ethanol over methanol, so it would prioritize metabolizing ethanol first. This stopped his liver from processing the methanol to formaldehyde and then to formic acid, giving him much needed time to undergo a medical procedure to clean his body of the methanol. Normally, doctors would use fomepizole or pure ethanol, but none was available. They then considered using wine, but they had no way of validating its origins because of the prevalence of bootleg alcohol in that area, and so they settled for name-brand beers instead. Yes, the beer was unorthodox, but Nhat regained consciousness after 15 hours and was discharged from the hospital 3 weeks later. Have you ever had alcohol from sketchy bars or shops, or your friend's backyard distillery? Do share your experiences below. And here are tips from the World Health Organization on how to protect yourself from methanol poisoning. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. For more interesting facts and stories, subscribe to our channel and click on the post notification button to know when we upload a new video. Remember, stay Fox curious.